Greetings, this is Bloodrill, and welcome back to Let's Play Shadowrun Dragonfall Director's Cut. Alright, we spend all our fucking money. And buying spells. Jesus, alright. I guess we can go do Blitz mission. And come back to things. Ah, really? Why do I have to meet with here? Alright, fine. Taking my dog to the meeting. Cheap booze. Found this liquor in my travels. Worth anything? No, not quite. Nah. Alright, I guess if we had the socialite etiquette, we could have gotten an expensive bottle. Alright, Frau Mueller. As you press your way forward through the cozy smoke-filled confines of Café Sesve, you catch sight of Frau Mueller. She appears, as Amsel described here, an impressive-looking woman of Astlander descent. What does that mean, Astlander descent? With coffee-colored skin and dark wavy hair. Everything about her screams corporate executive, from her expensive-looking suit to her tastefully understated makeup. She's obviously nervous, but she's hiding well. She locks eyes with you and hesitates only slightly before speaking. Phoenix, I presume Herr Amsel told me that I could meet you here. Alright. Yes, I do. In truth, I'm in desperate need of your help. Then tell me what you need, Frau Mueller. An assumed name, obviously, but I have been told that this is how you people do business. Apparently I don't have that. She straightens in her seat and tries on a smile. It hangs there for a second and then fades away. She sighs. From my accent you have no doubt inferred that I'm an Aslander. Further, you may have guessed who I work for. You tell me, I'm not in the business of guessing. As technology, the only Asland-based corporation operating in Germany. I've been with the company for over a decade. Over the course of my employment, I've worked on a great many projects. From the innocuous to the obscene, I have touched it all. My hands. Jesus. Never once did I question the wisdom of our research. Never once did I consider blowing the whistle on my employers. I kept my nose down, worked hard, and excelled at the tasks set before me. Last month, I was transferred here from my home in Tanok. Goddamn, Aztec names are even worse than Germans. Tanoktitlan. Let's hope they don't have to pronounce any of their gods because they have the most ridiculous names ever. Right. The only other detail that was given, the name of the project, Bloodline. She looks you in the eye and for the first time you can see the cracks in her composure. She's doing a fine job of hiding it, but deep down, this woman is terrified. I've seen many terrible things in my life, Phoenix. In Technoctilan, blood magic is commonplace. Take a moment to imagine what that means. In the underground markets, people are bought and sold as chattel. Street children are rounded up and bled like lambs. I witnessed all of these things by the age of 12. Seeing such things, it changes you, makes you numb. But what I found when I arrived here was even worse. This project, it horrifies me, Phoenix, and it must be stopped. Okay. The less you know, the better for both of us. You just have to trust me on that. You need only know that it is evil, and that it is not a word that I use lightly. Let's not get into philosophical discussions. You have to understand, Frau Mueller, I can't accept a job without knowing what it entails. Of course not. Your job will be relatively simple. I want you to bring the building down. the computers, the research data, the mages and scientists that are working to bring about this abomination. I want all of them burned to us and buried in a rumble. No compromises and no exceptions. No half measures, I am minding. Alright, I'm sure that you have unanswered questions. I'm not the habit of dealing with Shadowrunners. In truth, I've spent the majority of my career living in fear of you people. But I do know that you are the only ones who can get this done. So tell me, Phoenix, is there anything more that you need to hear from me? Paul Amser is my representative in these matters. Why could you tell all this to him? I had to meet you in person, to look into your eyes and see the woman behind the name. Now that I have done so, I am sure you are the one that I need. Naturally, I will send any further information about the job to Herr Amsel. What about any innocent people in the building? None of us are innocent, Phoenix. But if you need to salve your conscience, rest assured that at the hour of your approach, the only personnel authorized to be on site will be security and senior members of the research team. And I assure you, neither are innocent in this matter. If the Bloodline project reaches completion, nobody will be safe ever again. This sounds like hyperbole, I know, but it isn't. The Bloodline project will lead to countless deaths. Wow. I'm certain enough of this to hire you, despite the fact that doing so will probably cost me my own life. I'm not a demolitions expert, Frau Mueller. How do you expect me to level a building? You don't need to be. All that you need is a competent decker. The facility is powered by a number of on-site generators. There are safeguards in place to prevent them from overloading. In the event of power strike, the system is designed to shut itself down. But I know how you can disable those safeguards. Once the generators begin to overload, you'll have a limited time to reach a safe distance. The explosion will be quite catastrophic. Wow, okay. Security expected to be light, my ass. Yeah, I think she's lying about that. In addition to their standard security team, as technology have taken out a night errant high threat response. Team contract to protect the building, okay? Corporate doesn't seem to mind contracting a competitor for emergency response services. Yeah, that's not light security. At any rate, I believe I've come up with a solution to the night errant problem. I'll discuss the matter with your Amsel if you decide to take the job. 36,000 new, and as I told you, you're Herr Amsel, okay? Alright. I won't blow up an entire building full of people on such vague information. I'll take a job and see what happens. I will iron out the remaining details of your Heramsel. Okay. Who knows, this may batch me in the ass, but we'll see. She may just be a good actor, I guess. I hope I don't lose his side quest due to the linearity of the game right now. Frau Mueller has provided us with the information. Based on this intel, I have formulated what I believe will be an effective strategy. Okay. Whatever this Bloodline project is, the Aziz have spent no expense to defend it. The facility is patrolled by AS technology internal security personnel. On their own, they would pose a challenge, but I don't doubt that you will, that you could brute force your way through them. Unfortunately, they will not be on their own, as technology has purchased one of Knight Errant's more expensive security contracts as an additional live defense. That's not good. No, it's not. Knight Errant is too dangerous to take on directly. We have killed a bunch of them, but sure. But if we were to compromise their complex, could at least partially mitigate this danger. I pulled some strings with an old contact of mine that has provided me with the address of a small software developer, OTK International. They write the firmware updates for Knight Errant's comm system, and their defenses should be considerably weaker than AS technologies, as technology. My contact has informed me that OTK stores an off-site hard copy of every firmware update it develops for data security purposes. My suggestion is this: you hit the offices of OTK International and reduce their computers to slag. In the interim, I will have the hard copy of the next update replaced with a compromised version. Aha, so we need to do some work before hitting the AS technology facility, which is pretty good actually, pretty nice. This will give... yeah, alright. Yeah. Alright, we have two take the U-bands. How will that work exactly? I'm not sure. Alright, you know what? Let's see this third DVD. Play track 1. Alright, get them American dates. Whatever, one date. I was thinking about Adrian today. Not as he was when he disappeared, not as the famed Dragon Slayer or the big time CEO of DS Defense. I was thinking about when we were kids. Well, I was always more of a kid than he was, of course. He's 15 years older than me. In a way, he was more like a parent than a brother. So I was thinking about the time when we were on holiday. Our parents took us out the island of Poel to enjoy the beach. I must have been about 5 years old. Andrean was 20. It'd be his last family vacation with us. A year later, he'd begin his meteoric rise to fame and fortune. But on this trip, he was my brother. And when I fell out of the little paddle boat that our parents rented and started sinking fast into the Baltic, he was the one who dove in to rescue me. You saved my life that day, Adrian. I love you forever for that, and I will find you. Okay? 2049, I think that's 1 year later. Found an old news article that mentions Adrian from way back in 2036. It was printed in a financial magazine called something. One of those sick print-based mugs that they produced for the retro crowd. Das Finas Wesen. There aren't any clues in here, but it's good to see someone else acknowledge his existence. SK Stock suffers. SK Stock. In the aftermath of the Dragon Loftwheel's hostile takeover of Cider Group's... Sway Industries Shift. The company stock took a major hit when Loftwheel deposed former CEO Wilhelmina Graf Benoit last August. SK, I think that was the thing we read on Sunderland. Cider Group, okay? 3 months later, long-held power positions within the SKI empire continue to empty as the Dragon consolidates his power base. The most recent casualties of Loftwheel's takeover include Alexandra Kobayashi, former COO of Cider Munitions, Mathaus Donner, former treasurer of Ruch Datafax, and Werner Harding, former CEO of DL Defense. Harding stepped into the role to replace Dr. Adrian Vauclair, who disappeared under mysterious circumstances. Okay. So there you have it, that's what they have to say about Adrian a mere 2 years after his disappearance. My brother, the footnote. Clearly corrupted, rates, track 4, also corrupted. Track 5, Dr. Vauclair. 2034. It's my sad duty to inform you that by unanimous vote of the Offsicht, your position as CEO of DL Defense will be terminated at the end of this calendar month. Your continued misallocation of company funds to pursue personal agendas cannot and will not be tolerated any longer. The supervisory board is not unsympathetic to your mental state. The trauma that you endured during your pursuit of the dragon Feus Rwinge must have been enormous, but your continuing obsession with the dragon, the dead dragon I might add, has proven a negative influence on this company and an unjustified drain on company resources. The board wishes you all the best in your future endeavors. We have prepared a generous 7S package to assist you in this time of transition. If there is anything more that we can do to help you, please don't hesitate to ask. Harding. Okay. Nope. Thank you. Alright. We'll see if I can do his mission or I have to do the other mission. But before I leave, I need to remember to go and post that data for Shocken, Weather, Raider, whatever that thing is called. And talk to her maybe. And go down there maybe. But first... received 1000. Okay, it's not bad. Not great for the work it takes, but not bad. Alright, anything else to say here? Do you know anything about an organization called the Lodz? Dewar's group, you mean? Sure, I've done a few jobs for them. They pay well. The whole ominous secret organization thing they try to keep going is a little weird, but whatever, money is money. What can you tell me about Dewar? Best I can tell, he's a middle-ranked toady. Like any other corporate suit that you deal with before run. Alright, I think he's a little fresh-faced for what the Lodz has him doing. In the beginning, there were some credibility issues. Okay. I'm afraid that I can't help you dig any deeper, he's an occasional client. Even if I knew more about you, I wouldn't tell you. Shadowrunners who kiss and tell have a funny way of dying young. You said that you got a team in Mitte. I'd like to hear a little more about them. They are good people, they get the job done, what else do you need to know? How about names? Alright, we got Rakter, he's a rigger, an immigrant from the Russian Republic. Genius mechanic and engineer, the guy built his own crawler form Dawn and he's impressive as hell at piling it. Rakter, is that the guy from the Kickstarter of Hong Kong? Not sure, maybe. There's Barracuda, the team shaman. Elite card player. Okay. Hard to work with, solid. We're on the same page and nobody's afraid to speak his mind. We'll get how a crew of anarchist narrowrunners is supposed to work. Even Rakter, who is still pretty new to the scene here in Berlin. It gets tense from time to time, but it's supposed to get tense. Better that than to have to defer to a leader. Wow, okay. I've been meaning to ask, what's up with the tattooed circuitry? Is it purely decorative, or...? It is now, wasn't always though. What you're looking at used to be tattoo magic. Got it done when I was in Tokyo, doing a job for the Yakuza. Wow, cool. Right? 3 years ago. Tattoo magic, huh? That's a new one on me. Yeah, it was for me too. It's a meta-magic thing. A way of quickening spells to a person. Binding magic into the flesh. So that it's almost impossible to get rid of. Anyway, long story short, I found a way to break it. Now it just looks pretty in the lamplight. Why did you want to break it? What did the tattoos do before you broke them? So when I went to work to the Yaks, they offered, no, insisted that I let them ink me. Said I needed for the job. Long story short, tattoos did boost my abilities, but they also branded me. Marked me as Yakuza property and gave them an easy way of tracking me for the astral plane. Wow. How do you break the spell? It's an even longer story, and not one I want to get into. Suffice to say that it started with killing the guy who inked me and ended up in a pretty dark place. The upshot is that I can't go back to Japan, ever. Okay? So the moral of the story is, I guess, not to take any employer's word at face value. Yeah, no shit. Alright, I'll end this episode here. Thank you for watching. Subscribe, like, leave a comment if you want to, and I will see you next time.